Yeah. Underneath the core, get him, Paul. Only just ran onto the bend.
Right, we're away then for the final race of the competition, the 5,000 metre relay championship.
Pushing out in the lead.
Barry Arrington leads, Manny Banner second, Marcus White third. Fourth is Paul Horsburgh with 23 to go.
Okay, then.
to the presentation, first of all in the senior age group class, 800 metres, which was the final race, 14 to 15 year olds, in fourth place,
hey?
From Streatham, a big hand please for Lee Guest.
Zoomed in two ones.
In second place, the runner-up this year, and a very fine series of races you've had, from Nottingham, Steve Hunter.
Thank you.
The runner up in the closest of finishes in the 800 metres for the year, Stuart Wells, Nottingham. And the winner of the Humphrey Baker Cup, the British 800 metre champion, with a new track record of mention that she broke all the ladies' track records on her way to becoming British champion. Just wait for the photographs to finish. Excellent. We come now to the men's overall championship.
Welcome back. Recently, the second World Short Track Speed Skating Championships were held at the Coliseum at Moncton in Canada. The host country have dominated the sport, but a representation from Australia, Japan and Holland hoped to divide the Canadians. And Great Britain, who had high hopes of success, were also there. Commentary on the finals highlights from Phil Liggett.
Stuart Horsepool, the only non-Canadian skater having qualified for the final of this 1,000 metres World Championship on the inside, making a good start for the first bend, slotting into second place with Daniel, an 18-year-old wonder boy from Montreal, out in front. So nine laps of the ice, 111 metres each circuit of the ice, and of course the tactics completely different to the outdoor skating one normally sees in Olympic Games. These skaters specialists at the indoor track and tactics coming into play here, and Horsepool now in second place, really having to be very wary of the tactics being applied by these three Canadians in the final. Guy Danyot in the lead, in second place Horsepool. Horsepool gives way there but still holds his second place as Louis Grenier goes into the front now. Guy Danyot drops into third place there, and the fourth man wearing the hat is Boucher. Boucher, probably the most dangerous of all these skaters, a very explosive competitor and really a former world champion and world outdoor record holder. Horsepool now going out in front and looking very, very impressive here in this 1,000 metres. A really excellent chance for Britain to win a medal here, but a challenge for the corner there by Grenier, and really Grenier takes the ice on the inside, and that to me looks like a possible disqualification for the Canadian there.